Everyone, and welcome to my review of the Edifier Lunas. Well, I've had a little while to play with them, so now I'm going to do a review on them. The very first thing you'll notice is their design. It is extremely striking. You will notice them from a distance, and the first thing you'll think is there's no way they're a set of computer speakers. But they are, but they have other uses as well. They have Bluetooth. They work pretty well for small parties. I've tried. Anyway, let's have a look at the design. First thing you'll notice is the colouring and the front force. You can get these in many different colours. I have mine in red because I like red. Red goes faster. Also, you'll notice this big gap here. You may be wondering, is there a port in there? Well, kind of. It is a passive radiator. In fact, there are two of them. Two 3-inch passive radiators. Now, the idea of a passive radiator is instead of having a port somewhere inside this, or in the back, they have two drivers without magnets on them, and they move to the main woofer. Now, the idea of that is there's no port noise. They can tune the passive radiator, and they'll use a long port inside the box, which saves space. And it does look cool. I'll give them that. Alright, the first thing you notice in the front is the driver array. It has a 0.75-inch dome silk tweeter and a 3-inch inverted coned woofer, which handles the mid-bass as well. It does a pretty good job. You turn them around, you'll notice they have a port for the wire to go in. You'll notice it has six terminals. The same with the wire, which, mind you, clicks in really nice and solidly. You got to pull it pretty hard to get it out. It clips in there quite nicely. Anyway, let's have a close look at this. Because this is also something you do not see very often in the computer speakers. Or any speakers under $1,000, when you come to think of it. These are two-way active loudspeakers. You may notice four of these are for the woofer and the other two are for the tweeter. These actually have four amplifiers inside. Two amps do the low, and the other two channels do the highs, and they have an active crossover and digital sound processor inside, which handles it all for them. Which, for the price of them, which, you know, they're $2.99 in Australia, which you may look at and go, that's a lot of money for such a small little speaker. But the sound quality they put out is exceptionally good, especially for the size. The bass they produce is amazing. I'm not just saying that because I like Edifier. They actually do produce a solid amount of bass. And the treble is just crisp. They did very good choosing on the drivers. They matched really well. There's no phase issues between the drivers. Even when you put your head up really close to them, there's no problem. Anyway, this one here is the speaker with the amplifier. If you got the way, I'll bring you a little closer. So all the power wires go into the back of this one. And also, your 3.5mm jack goes in there as well. But you don't have to use that. You can use Bluetooth because they support Bluetooth. Now, to turn them on is pretty simple. My fingers are oily because I am actually quite hot. There we go. I'm not running the air conditioner because it makes a bit of noise and you'll hear it in the video. Now, the first thing they're going to do is if you've paired a phone with them before, or an iPad or a computer, they're going to search for that. And that's actually what they've done. All you've got to do to connect to your Bluetooth is go to your Bluetooth settings, paired devices, it'll come up Edifier Lunar Eclipse, connect, and it will come to a blue light. And then you can easily go in, find your favorite piece of music, anything you want will play through them. Hit play. No problem. That easy. Anyway, we'll connect the other speaker up, which is an easy thing to do. All you gotta do, it'll only go in one way. You can't, no matter what you do, it's not gonna go in that way. It has the two marks. It even says up on it as well. It's got little notches here. So it'll only go in one way, and it's in there quite well too. Also comes with a wireless remote control, which is quite a nice looking remote, especially considering most computer speakers have those little card shaped ones, which they don't look very good. But these are definitely built with style in mind. This can control the volume, power, and if you keep your finger on it, it does other commands as well, like changes your settings. Now, as you can see, the light's still blue, it is still connected. Now, for sound quality, they sound like a speaker worth a whole lot more. The very first thing you're going to think is, oh, these are an expensive speaker for this size. But once you listen to them, even in the shop, where, it's a giant shop, there's no walls for the bass to bounce off, you should put these near a corner or near a wall so the sound, so the bass can reverberate at the back. That makes it sound a lot nicer. Behind here is just some cardboard boxes anyway, so it's not going to produce great amounts of bass. And this is fabric, so fabric to a point absorbs bass. But hey, let's give it a little go anyway. Turning up the volume from the speaker is easy. You just push this button here and you'll see this light is going, it's flashing at you. Easy to control. I'm not too sure how good this will be recorded, but we'll give it a little go so you guys can hear it. What keeps the planet spinning? The force from the beginning. I don't know if you guys can hear it as well as I can. The voice is very crisp. There's a part in this song, which is up here, it's when they clap their hands. A lot of speakers, especially in this price bracket, the clap sounds really artificial. Like it sounds like it's being reproduced. And when you're playing back music, you don't want it to sound like it's reproduced. But it sounds like a real clap. That's a Bobby Dazzler in my opinion. Even set up like this, the bass response on them is pretty exceptional. I mean, it's not brilliant because, well, there's nothing for it to reverberate off. But the treble in the mid-range is perfectly crisp. You could happily use these in a studio. And it would give you a pretty good, accurate sound reproduction of what someone else is going to hear when they play it for their systems. Which, for that price range, is amazing. Especially when you've got features like, two-way active. You don't see that. Especially not at this price range. It's something you don't see, which is amazing for... It's amazing that no one else has really done this before. Edifier have done so many things innovative in the computer speaker industry. Like when they bought out the S760, S730, S750, they were big speakers. And you could easily compare them to a home theater system, double the price of the speakers. And now they've continued on with their excellence with the Luna series, which are just a fantastic looking speaker. You really can't deny how beautiful they look. It's got Edifier written in it. E25. Luna. But they're exceptionally good speakers. And I have to say, my personal opinion is I enjoy them very much. If there's any negatives I have, any complaints, it's really nitpicking actually at the moment. But they don't have a subwoofer output. The Spinnakers, the next model up from these, the big cone-shaped speakers, they have an RCA output for a subwoofer, which I think these would have really benefited from. It would have turned it into a brilliant 2.1 channel home theater system. It would have been great. But, it's just nitpicking. They really are a great speaker for what they are, and I definitely recommend them to someone who wants, one, a speaker that looks good, two, a speaker that sounds good, because these do sound exceptional. And I love that they put the logo on the side like that. That looks good. They could have put it down here. That would have looked good, but I really think, my personal opinion is, it looks really good where it sits. Anyway, I don't think there's too much more to talk about with them. They are a good speaker, and I recommend them. It'll be interesting to see what Edifier comes out with next. Thanks for watching, guys.